Hey, it's SGU, and I'm bringing you Joe Broadway's Road to the Show today here in MLB The Show 18 on the PS4. Now, Joe was having a great year. Yankees trying to climb back in this race, and today we are playing ball in Baltimore.
Tuesday night baseball from Oriole Park here in Baltimore. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the New York Yankees and the Baltimore Orioles. These two will have a likely impact in this series. Game one is next.
All right, so Joe Broadway steps in for his first at-bat of this game with an awesome, amazing 66 home runs to this point. And looking for more, that's not going to be a home run. That's a smash to short. However, it was not handled. I don't know if that's an error or a hit, but he reached his base either way. I think they're going to give him a hit on the play. Joe Broadway, let's take a look at the replay here. See what the shortstop had to deal with. Well, maybe we won't see his perspective, and more so just ISO'd on Joe's swing. So he's at first base, and the manager wants him to steal. Everyone knows Joe is not the fastest, but he can pick his spots and steal bases, and they're going to pitch out. That's not a good sign. Oh, wow. How do you not get him when you're pitching out? I mean, it's not Skeeter Rabbit. He can steal on pitch outs any day, but this is Joe Broadway we're talking about. And against the lefty, I guess he gets just enough of a good jump. And, of course, the throw is a little high. That aids him as well. But, man, stealing on a pitch out, pretty crazy. Now he's going to be put in motion when this ball is hit deep to right field. You better go back. You better get back. I don't think he's going to get back. Yeah, he got doubled off, and that's the end of the inning. So a little bit of trouble base running right there. After the steal, he gets doubled off a second base. Thought maybe that ball was hit out. I don't know. But you got to be a little cautious there. 1-0 is the score. So Broadway comes up again, and this is a 2-0 game now in favor of the Yankees. You got a runner on, and this ball is hit to left field. Seems to be fairly deep. Could this be number 67? Yeah, no, yeah. Joe didn't think so. He started retreating to first base. But he's elated to find out it did indeed clear the wall. It's now 4-0 Yankees. That's number 67 on the season. Broadway coming through with another bomb. And the Yankees looking to continue their hot pace. Remember, we had that huge winning streak going a little while back. And that's over now, of course. And we still have a lot of ground to make up against the Red Sox. But, hey, this team is trending in the right direction, above 500 now. Playing winning baseball, and just trying to have the second half of their lives here to try to make this interesting in the race against the Red Sox. They got a long way to go, but this game looks to be in hand. They're up 7-0. Broadway's going to strike out on that one. High fastball that he cannot connect with. So send it into the seats once, but this time around, as you see the sequence of pitches in the at-bat, keeping it low, and then he works up high and gets him swinging. Changing that eye level, so important to a pitcher to be able to do that. 8-0 Yankees now. We're out in the field. There's one out. This is hit to his right down the line. He's able to backhand it, throw over to first, and get the out. Good job by Joe right there. Solid. As he's taking one away from Manny Machado, who, oh, by the way, just got traded to the Dodgers in real life. No longer a Baltimore Oriole. What do you guys think about that trade? Manny finally being dealt and to the Dodgers. Of course, in our versions of things here, we're in, what, 2022, and he's still with the Orioles? So very much a different alternate reality, and one where Broadway hits a no-doubt shot for his second of the game. It's now 9-0, and he has hit number 68 now on the season, approaching 70 home runs. Oh, boy. Absolutely crushing it. And, of course, what's that? Is he caught on the line there? Is he a flopping fish? I'm not sure exactly what he was going for right there. You're going to see the ball trail as he hits this one very high, way back, and into that second section of seats there on the lower level. So he's 3-for-4 with 2 homers and a single and 4 big RBI on the day. Baltimore does score, making it 9-2. This one hit to third base. They're going to turn two. Joe, you don't need to be doing that. Only thing that's going to be accomplished there is you jamming something and getting hurt. We've seen it before with Jack Hammer and others. That's a dangerous precedent to be sliding into first base right there when not necessary. So, Yankees do win the game. Joe hits 2 big flies. and he's now at 68 on the season. Yankees celebrated another victory, 9 runs, 11 hits. You see, 11 hits for Baltimore as well, but just 2 runs mustered out of that. Means we stranded a lot of runners, apparently. So, that game in the books. What do we got next? Are we jumping forward to another series, or are we staying here in Baltimore? Let's find out. Our initiative with a lot of the Road to the Show characters is to kind of move things along a little faster, a little more rapid rate, as I don't want these guys to like end today, but I want these guys to progress towards their natural end of their careers and hopefully Hall of Fame careers for guys like Broadway and guys like Meyer and Billy Bravo and all the ones that have been around for a few years here, Skeeter Rabbit. So we take this in to Kansas City now, and looks like they've got a quality club. 67-53 is their record, so it looks like we may have some rain or moisture in the air today. A little bit of fog, whatever it is. Hopefully we can see the pitches from Justin Grimm well enough to get our offense going. So we're now at 70 home runs. He got to that even 70 number. Of course, looking to try to break his own record that he set last season. He ended up last year's historic season with 76 home runs, so he is the all-time single-season king, but he's given himself a run this year as they got plenty of baseball to play. He gets a single right here and will be on base. So let's see what the Yankees can do as far as damage against the Royals. Well, nothing. We have a scoreless game still, and he's out at third base. Going to go ahead and run in and backhand this and throw over. Very routine play at third base. But we got to handle them all just the same. So we got another at bat coming up, or are we still on the field? Nope. Second at bat of the game. 1-for-1 with that single. Looking to do more damage against the Royals. Kansas City up 1-0 in the game. That is going to be hit to short, and I don't think they'll have any problem throwing him out here. Oh, there he goes with that diving again. You scare me, Joe. Pretty soon we're going to see you're injured, and all of a sudden we're out of any chance to try to get back in a pennant race. Here is a force at second base that'll end the inning. Joe and that ridiculous hair of his. Man, I still don't approve of that haircut. I think it's wild. I think he looks, I don't know what he looks like exactly, but it doesn't look great. You know what looks great is this swing. Deep to left. That one is not coming back. Cuts through the fog into the seats. And he is struck again. Number 71 now on the season. As again, he's inching closer to a familiar name in the record book. Oh, yeah, his own name, himself. He's trying to catch his own record. And, oh, I guess we're going to do a wheelbarrow coming around third base. Just yucking it up a little bit here. Getting some laughs, getting some celebration in. Yes, the stuff really is over the top, and at some point we'll probably stop using it. But it's just too much fun to see all the varied over-the-top home run reactions this year. I know every once in a while somebody's like, oh, yeah, that's a dislike for crazy animations in a sim game. I don't know. Come on. It's fun. We're making videos. We're having fun. Anyway, 3-1 Kansas City right now. That's going to get past Joe out into left field. And it's going to score another run. Kansas City now up 4-1. And the game itself is not going exactly how we want it to. 7-1 now. Oh, boy. This ball hit the left. It's going to stay in the ballpark, isn't it? Isn't it? Oh, maybe not. Okay, that was weird. I swear I saw the ball like hit the warning track, but apparently went over the wall. I don't know if that's a glitch or what. What happened out here? He hit it very high. It's already kind of misty, rainy, whatever, but it might have brought rain. It was so high. Oh, I see. It landed in the bullpen out in the grassy area there. Looked like it was still in play somehow, but it was just a little trick to the eye. So that's his second home run of the game. Royals win, but we're now at, what, 72 home runs on the season and a lot of baseball left to play. So, all right. I'm guessing we're checking out of Kansas City now. We're going to fast forward. Let's find out what we do here on the calendar and what game action we will see next. You see 2 home runs on the ledger there for Broadway. And let's go ahead and sim forward. Where are we going to end up? Kansas City's out. Oh, at Boston. Of course, the first place Boston Red Sox and our bitter rival. We've got to check in on this one. Absolutely a must. So, Red Sox hosting this series. They're the ones with the advantage in the division, obviously. And a pretty hefty one still, but beating up on them here at Fenway would go a long way to keeping us where we want to be. And that's at the very least in good wild card position. So, well, he's up to 74 now. Just two away from tying his own record. And he's in a very hitter-friendly ballpark here at Fenway. Let's see what kind of damage he can do here in this game and in this series. Stepping in here with two runners on, and he's going to hit it high. And he's going to hit it out to center field where it should be able to be played, and it is caught. So he's going to fly out in his first at-bat and look for better the next time around, which is right now, 0-for-1. But stepping in again here, looks like the weather in Kansas City followed us to Boston, as once again it is kind of a wet and drizzly evening. For this at-bat, Joe's going to find himself with the bases loaded in a scoreless game. It could be not so scoreless if he gets a hold of one. And instead, with two outs, he's going to pop up on the infield. So a missed opportunity right there to crack it open in favor of the Yankees. And Red Sox still do not have a hit. It's early, however, and I'm sure that'll change as now they have a run and they've got a runner at third. And Joe finally gets out of his crouch and decides to field this pop-up. And he does so without a problem. So hoping to keep Boston right there at just one run scored. That is the case. So we come up for another at-bat, trying to zero in on this pitch, and he hits it hard, but he hits it as short. There's one out, and again with that slide. Oh, I have to cover my eyes when he does that. Please don't get injured. Yeah, he hit into a double play, so it remains 1-0 Boston. Can't seem to get on the board as of yet. This one he's going to run in on to the infield grass and a strong throw, and he gets him by a couple steps. So good play right there. But he's 0-for-3. He really needs a hit. And preferably a home run would really help out the Yankees right here. Well, instead, he's going to hit it through the infield out into left. So he's got himself a single. So at least he's reached base. What can the lineup behind him do now as he says, come on, let's get it going. You see a replay of this as they're hugging the third baseline. And that's one of the reasons he's able to draw this through on out to the outfield. So now at first base, thinking about taking off, he will take off. The ball put into play. Come on, reach the gap. Reach the gap. It's down for a hit. He's not able to catch it. Now, Joe, a late reaction to go to third. He still gets there. Whew. Almost cost him there, that hesitation, but it's all good. It's all good. He gets to third base, going first to third on this hit. There was some question about whether it'd be caught or not. It drops to the grass, and so with no outs, runners at the corners, and this one hit to right field. This should score, Joe. The catch is made. He's off to the plate. The throw is cut off, and the relay is not in time. So the game is all tied on a sacrifice fly. Good thing Joe did get over to third base because he's able to score on this play. A little bit of hustle from New York gets them all squared away. So where do we go from here? You got another at-bat for Broadway, now 1-for-4. But what's our score? That's the most important thing to find out right here. Are we still tied? Yes, we are. There's two runners on. There's one out. There's a 2-1 count. And Broadway hits it in the air. I don't think this is leaving the ballpark. Center fielder should be under this. Actually, it's the left fielder making the catch in front of the scoreboard and going to get this back into the infield as quick as he can. Yankees apparently go on to win the game because we're celebrating when all is said and done. That's good. Get us a game closer to the division leaders. We'll have to check where we're at with that, hopefully before we're out. But we get a game against the Red Sox. How does the rest of the series go? We'll have to check that as well. 14 hits to get 3 runs. And are we going to see the standings? Please. Nope, no standings. All right, well, we're just inching closer. And we'll see you next time for more Joe Broadway. Hopefully catch those Red Sox.